I welcome you this afternoon, both here and from far away. Thank you for joining in at this time where we remember Trevor, and we honor his presence in our lives, and we commit him to God's gracious care and keeping. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am resurrection and I am life. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and is committed to me in faith shall not die forever." And Paul wrote to the believers, "I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God found in Christ Jesus our Lord." We will have our opening music now, and it will be "To Sir with Love." Please bow your heads in prayer. God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Show compassion to your people in their sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength to lift us from the darkness of grief to the peace and light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us, conquered death, and by rising again, restored life. May we then go forward eagerly to meet him, and after our life on earth, be reunited with our brothers and sisters, where every tear will be wiped away. We ask this through Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. I invite you to turn to your order of service, to the inside page, and we will say together Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. He revives my soul and guides me along right pathways for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I invite Roxanne to come forward and read God's law for us.
God saw your mother getting tired and a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around her and whispered, "Come to me." With tearful eyes you watched her and saw her pass away. Although you loved her dearly, you could not make her stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hard-working hands at rest. God broke your heart to prove he only takes the best. Although it's difficult today to see beyond the sorrow, may looking back in memory help comfort you tomorrow.
Thank you. And Jen, I invite you to come forward for our first scripture reading.
The first reading is Revelation chapter 21, verses 3 to 6. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life."
Thank you, Jim. Our selection of music for this time is What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Trish,
I invite you to come forward for our second Bible reading.
John 14, verse 1 to 6. Jesus, the way to the Father. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and I prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may also be. And you may know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Michael, I invite you to come for the eulogy.
Good afternoon, folks. Thanks for coming. Everybody online, appreciate everybody's coming out. Just gonna briefly give you back a little history of my father and most of you know him as Trevor. I know him as Dad. He was born February 25th, 1942, Trevor Henry Benjamin. Enter this world. He was a handsome young man born in San Fernando, Trinidad and Tobago, to proud parents Lionel and Doris. Trevor, or Benji, as he was known, moved to Toronto somewhere in the late 60s as a young man, where he completed his education at Sheridan College, majoring in machinist program. From there on, he went to complete his degree at Teachers College. Along the way, he had four kids with Cora, Beverly, Michael, Trisha, Corin. While working tirelessly as a machinist for CP Rail, years later, he was fortunate enough to pursue his career as a teacher at Sheridan College for over 30 years. And he eventually held a title as department coordinator for the machine department. In and around the summer of 81, Trevor and Kathleen met, and they fostered an unconditional bond and love that would never been broken, and eventually made a decision to retire here in Collingwood. My dad was a very modest man. He took great pleasures in the small things. He loved singing, dancing, while he was cooking in the kitchen. Kathy can attest to that. Nathan and I just found out the other day, he kept a detailed list of his TV shows and times and dates of what it was. So, man was very, very organized. He loved watching TV. Yeah. I guess he didn't trust the Rogers or Bell guide. That's why he did that. They also enjoyed long walks in Collingwood, even attempting to walk up the Blue Mountain, which I thought was crazy, but he tried it anyways. I think he got halfway and then had to turn around. He made it halfway and then turned around. Some of his greatest pleasures were driving. They drove across country to BC, the other way, cross country, out east, PEI, Nova Scotia, places like that. And Kathy reminded me also that they made sure they stopped at every Tim Hortons to get a bite and his favorite coffee. Also, trips to San Francisco was another one of his favorite trips that he made. Just have a few fun facts about Dad. I'm pretty sure he could have made his own or had his own HDTV show, because he was Mr. DIY. He had many projects on the go at home. Kitchen, the living room, flooring, the basement, just lots of DIY projects. He was also a huge sports fan, loved soccer, football. Our favorite team, and he introduced me to football, and we were huge Cowboy fans. Cricket, big ping pong player, loved playing ping pong, and pool, Blue Jays, loved the baseball. And very interesting thing, they made it all the way up here and joined a bowling league and actually won the championship for the bowling league, which I thought was really, really amazing. He was also a bit of an entrepreneur in his own right. He made, I didn't bring any samples today, but he made, when I went to college, I asked him to make a mechanical pen. For me to draw with. I used that for 3 years. I used that pen. It's made out of aluminum. And he made meat tenderizer, jewelry boxes. I think Bev has a jewelry box, and Kathy has one too. And he also made a chess set for yachting. It was really interesting. He explained it to me that each piece had some sort of filling in it, so that when you're on the boat, on a yacht, the pieces wouldn't tip over because you're on the water. So major feat that he did that. And he was also an amazing kite maker. I have a bit of a apology to make, because every summer I would ask him to make a kite for us, myself and my boys, but I would tell a little lie and tell him that the boys needed it. They really wanted to do it. They really wanted to fly the kite, but meanwhile, it was really for me because I just love flying kites with him. I missed that. My dad was forever gentle, giving, and never judgmental. He was always ready and willing to listen, provide comfort, and help in any way possible. Regardless of the issue, he had the ability to provide solace when needed to others. From the monthly barbecues that we all enjoyed, the holiday dinners, the home was filled with constant love and joy from friends and family. For this, he will always be remembered and deeply missed. His amazing warrior spirit and his perseverance are all qualities that allowed him to overcome numerous obstacles at every turn in life. But sadly, on Friday, April 30th, 3:15 p.m., God saw that he was tired and care was not to be. So he took his arms around him and whispered, "Come to me." Trevor, my dad is survived by his children, Beverly, myself, Trisha, Corin, Nathan, Jessica, his grandchildren, Justine, Jalen, Kayan, Jeremiah, Austin, Aria, his brothers and sisters, Everett, Esther, Carol, and many, many close friends. You're gonna be missed. Thank you.
Let us now come before God in prayer. When I say, "In your mercy," please respond, "Hear us, Lord." Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together in one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. In your mercy, hear us, Lord. May all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection die to sin and rise to newness of life. And may we with him pass through the grave and gate of death to our joyful resurrection. In your mercy, hear us, Lord. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. In your mercy, hear us, Lord. Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. In your mercy, hear us, Lord. Give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. In your mercy, hear us, Lord. Grant us grace to entrust Trevor to your never-failing love, which sustained him in this life. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, and remember him according to the favor you bear for your people. In your mercy, hear us, Lord. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please join with me in saying the commendation on the top of page 2. Give rest, O Christ, to your servants with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of all, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, You are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servants with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Into your merciful hands, O Savior, we commend your servant, Trevor Henry. Acknowledge, we pray, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of grace and God of glory, we thank you for Trevor, who was so near and dear to us, but who has now been taken from us. We thank you for the friendship he gave and for the strength and peace he brought. We thank you for the love he offered and received while he was with us on earth. We pray that nothing good in Trevor's life will be lost, but will be of benefit to the world, that all that was important to him will be respected by those who follow, and that everything in which he was great will continue to mean much to us now that he is gone from us. We ask you that Trevor go on living in his children, his family and friends, in their hearts and in their minds, in their courage and their consciences. We ask you that we who were close to him may now, because of his death, be even closer to each other, and that we may, in peace and friendship here on earth, always be deeply conscious of your promise to be faithful to us in death. May God grant us courage and confidence in the new life of Christ. We ask this in the name of the risen Lord. Amen. The eternal God is your dwelling place, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Blessed is the Lord, our strength and our salvation. Please stand for the blessing. And now may the peace of God that passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you and all those whom you love, this day and forevermore. Amen. Thank you for joining us this afternoon, and I thank those who have been watching online. Please be assured of the prayers of the All Saints Faith Community over the coming weeks. You will be held in thought and prayer. Thank you.